LDN is an opioid receptor antagonist, right? So that is, it blocks the opioid receptor for a short amount of time. Its half-life is roughly 4 to 6 hours. And then when it releases, you do get this wave of endorphins that come in. Second effect that I know Sarah will want to talk on more is it is a toll-like receptor 4 antagonist. And this is where you see the autoimmune effects coming, right? It's blocking toll-like receptor 4 and then all of those excitatory cytokines, basically. So there's kind of, it's kind of like a twofold type of mechanism of action there for the drug.
Mm-hmm. So it's going to have multiple effects. So number mm-hmm. one is it's going to affect opioid receptors in different ways. We have a ton of different opioid receptors. And in fact, at the LDN conference that we had in person last year, Dr. Sebastian Dennison, who's a pharmacist friend of mine, he and I are both immunologist, microbiologist nerds. And he was talking about how there was just another opioid receptor that had been discovered, right? It's kind of like, to me, the immune system and the microbiome is kind of like outer space or the sea. We know so little about it. And the LDN is going to block those receptors briefly, but they're going to have different affinity for the receptors. So for instance, mu opioid receptors are for pain traditionally, and we know that LDN has excellent blockade of that. And it's a partial opioid antagonist. So we're going to blockade it briefly. It's going to kiss that receptor. When it unblocks, you're going to get an increase in your own body's endorphins. So beta endorphins, which traditionally mood, pain, sleep, and metenkephalins. So metenkephalin is also known as opioid-derived growth factor. And that is on so many tissues of the body. And this is where it gets really fascinating. So I'm so excited that Sam brought up TLRs because I have been writing about toll-like receptors in my kind of contribution to the trust. But there are at least 13, I think, TLRs now, and toll-like receptor 4 is the main one. But we think of toll-like receptors as gates. But basically, these are triggered. These gates get triggered by antigens or signals, molecular signals that are traditionally either danger signals that are being released from cells, like they're getting inflamed or they're dying, or from actual pathogens like bacteria or viruses and things. And unfortunately, in patients who are prone to autoimmune disease, these toll-like receptors go berserk and they get chronically inflamed and activated. So in specifically in the central nervous system or in the gut. And once they get turned on, there's not a lot of good ways to turn those off. And so what myself and a colleague have coined this as, we call LDN a pan-specific toll-like receptor attenuator, meaning it's not going to shut those TLRs down, but it's going to stop them from being so gosh darn overactive, which is really important for long COVID and really important for autoimmune disease and other conditions where we know for a fact that TLRs are being activated as that mechanism. Dr. Leonard Weinstock is another dear contributor to the trust. He's a GI out in St. Louis, and he has discussed that it is also, that LDN is working on aberrant T cells. Some of my colleagues and I, we now have shown that that is also working on the fact that there are what we call aberrant monocytes, other cells, which are just not working properly for the immune system. And in the case of long COVID, are chronically activated. We're talking a year and a half after infection. So if we can actually target those cells that are not working properly and try to get them on the right track and deflame the system, we can help much better. And there are a lot of other effects of naltrexone on tissues. But in general, we can sum it up as anti-inflammatory and immune modulatory. And a big question I get all the time, just I'm going to head this off the pass, is that people say, well, what do you mean it's going to boost the immune system? Don't we not want to overemphasize an already overactive immune system? Do we not want to make it too active? No, that's not what LDN is doing. It is modulating the immune system to support it. And the kind of originators of the protocol, Dr. Ian Zeigon, who's done so much research on naltrexone, and then Dr. Bernard Bahari was a neurologist in New York City, and he was kind of the first guy who had this crazy, you know, he started putting this crazy idea into practice of using a low dose of a drug that was already FDA approved, naltrexone, and he used it on MS patients at a time where there were no treatments for MS in the late 70s, early 80s, and then this disease came to New York City, AIDS, mm-hmm. and he was one of the first doctors that was treating, because he was a neurologist, and he treated his AIDS patients, his HIV patients with naltrexone, and he got significant benefit for those patients to help, at least for a time, their immune system when there was no treatment for HIV. And so we kind of stand on the shoulders of these people that did those early works to say, okay, what is LDN really doing? And we're learning so much more. The papers, so just started in 2014, the papers were barely there. And we're having this renaissance of so much what we call basic science, but it's the animal studies and the models, the cell models and things that are looking at toll-like receptors because of COVID. And it's really exciting to say, and frustrating, because we had papers in 2020 saying that TLR activation was a huge reason why people were dying of COVID sepsis. And I was screaming from the rooftop saying we should be using LDN on all of our patients. And I don't want to get political about it, but it took basically this pandemic that's affected our entire populace, our entire human population, to then say, okay, we want to do research in this area. And lo and behold, LDN has a place in the treatment.
I've seen a lot of really interesting things with long COVID. I'm sure you have too. I mean, the patients, COVID was okay for them. It wasn't that severe, but then their long-term effects are severe, or, you know, they had severe COVID, but maybe their long-term effects weren't that severe. So it's a very interesting thing, but I've seen LDN help in both situations, especially as more and more people have long COVID. It's really changed the game there. It's been very interesting to just see, because they all come out of COVID with completely different side effects of somebody else, but then they're all seeing positive benefits. So it's very interesting.